Hi everyone, this is Teacher Jane of Teach Talk, where learning is fun and easy. If this is your first time watching our videos, don't forget to subscribe and click that bell button so you'll get notified on our next videos. Welcome to Shenzhen Amazing! Kung saan pag-uusapan natin ang mga science concepts from grade 7 to grade 12, kasama ang topics in general science, biology, chemistry, physics, and earth science. At dito, bidang agham. The majestic Mount Arayat in Pampanga towers over the largest plain in central Luzon. In Pangasinan, the Hundred Islands are famous for their white sand beaches, caves, and limestone rocks. These islands, which are believed to have formed more than 2 million years ago, are also teeming with marine life. We also have the perfect cone volcano, which is Mount Mayon. Palawan is rich in beautiful beaches, and the Sierra Madre mountain range covers a large part in Luzon. In our Shenzhen Amazing episode for today, we will be going from the globe to the Philippines. We will be discussing the physical features of the Philippines, starting with Luzon. The Philippines is made up of 7,641 islands. It is an archipelago. An archipelago is a group of islands or an area of sea where there are many islands. The word archipelago is a term derived from the Greek expressions archi, which means chief, and pelagos, which means sea. The term refers to any sea with many islands, or such group of islands. The country is divided into three geographic areas. These are Luzon, which is the largest of the 7,641 islands. Then Mindanao, which is the second largest. And Visayas, composed of the principal islands of Samar, Negros, Panay, Mindoro, Leyte, Cebu, and Bohol. Let's start with Luzon. According to its topography, Luzon can be divided into 8 topographic regions. We have 2 plains, the Ilocos Coastal Plain and Central Plain, 3 cordilleras, the Central Cordillera, Eastern Cordillera, and Western Cordillera. Among these 8 topographic regions, merong dalawang volcanic regions. First, the volcanic Taal region and volcanic Mayon region. And the 8th topographic region is Cagayan Valley. If you can notice, iba-iba ang physical features at topography ng mga places in Luzon. So we will be discussing these topographic regions one by one. Una, Ilocos Coastal Plain. This is a narrow strip of land facing the West Philippine Sea o tinatawag na South China Sea. It is located at the western side of northern Luzon. Sand dunes, which are hills or ridges of sand piled up by the wind, are characteristic features of the sandy coastal plain. Ito ang mga sand dunes. Another plain in Luzon is the Central Plain. This is the largest level lowland east of the Zambales mountain range. The only highland in this plain is Mount Arayat, located in Pampanga. Another prominent feature is the Candaba Swamp at the boundary of Pampanga and Bulacan. You can see a part of the Candaba Swamp in this picture. Let's have another trivia. Did you know that the Candaba Swamp is a complex of freshwater ponds, swamps, and marshes? It is surrounded by grasslands and palm savanna. During the rainy season, the entire area is flooded as it serves as a natural flood retention basin from nearby rivers. Most of it dries up during the dry season and is used for planting rice and watermelon. But what is special about Candaba Swamp is that it is a haven for both local and migratory waterfowl. Ano ang mga waterfowl? These are birds that are strong swimmers with waterproof feathers and webbed feet. And this just proves that the Philippines is rich in natural resources that many birds live in here. Let's continue with the 8 topographic regions. Punta na tayo sa tatlong cordillera, starting with Central Cordillera. The Central Cordillera is a mountain region stretching from Kalinga to Benguet. Its highest point is 3,000 meters above sea level. Kung makikita natin sa mapa, the Central Cordillera stretches from Kalinga to Benguet. Bakit tinatawag na central ang cordillera na ito? Because it is located in the center of Luzon. If you can see, the mountain range stretches from Kalinga to Benguet and is located in the center part. The parts which is shown in brown color represent the Central Cordillera. Ang ikalawang cordillera sa Luzon ay ang Eastern Cordillera o ang Sierra Madre Mountains. This is the longest mountain system of the country at the eastern side of Luzon facing the Pacific Ocean. It covers the provinces Cagayan, Isabela, Nueva Vizcaya, Quirino, Nueva Ecija, Aurora, and Quezon Province. Its highest point is 2 meters above sea level. The Sierra Madre Mountains are called Eastern Cordillera because they are located in the east. In the picture, you can clearly see how long these mountains are. Since it faces the Pacific Ocean and is near the Philippine Sea, it is prone to typhoons. This is good because it serves as a typhoon barrier, weakening incoming typhoons from the Pacific Ocean before reaching the central mainland. It is Luzon's strongest defense against typhoons. Ang ikatlo sa ating mga cordillera ay ang Western Cordillera. This is also called the Zambales Mountain Range. The mountain range extends from the northwestern part of Pangasinan to the Bataan Peninsula in the south. The following mountains are located in this range: Mount Pinatubo, High Peak, Mount Natib, Mount Samat, and Mount Mariveles. The Zambales Mountain Range is called Western Cordillera because it is located in the west. It is almost beside the West Philippine Sea or South China Sea in the picture. It stretches from Pangasinan to Bataan. We are done with the cordilleras. Now let's proceed to the two volcanic regions in Luzon. Let's start with the southwestern volcanic region with Taal at the center. This region has volcanic upland, plains, and lakes. The prominent features are Taal Volcano, Taal Lake, Laguna Dibay, Mount Makiling, and Mount Banahaw. When you were younger, you might have known Taal as the small volcano seen in the picture. Actually, this volcano is just one of the craters of Taal Volcano. This is called Binintiang Malaki. The real Taal Volcano is spread behind Binintiang Malaki. In a bird's eye view, you can see Binintiang Malaki right here, but the main crater lake of Taal is actually located here. This is another picture comparing Binintiang Malaki and Taal Volcano. Recently, Taal Volcano has erupted in its main crater. Another volcanic region in Luzon is the southwestern volcanic region with Mayon at the center. This covers the irregularly shaped Bicol Peninsula. The prominent features are volcanic peaks like Mount Mayon. Mount Mayon is the most iconic out of all the volcanoes in the Philippines because of its perfect cone-shaped majestic view. Aside from Mayon, we can also see lakes and other volcanoes in Bicol region. In this picture, we can see Mount Iriga or Mount Asog on top of Lake Buhi. And finally, the last topographic region we're going to discuss is the Cagayan Valley. The Cagayan Valley lies between the Central Cordillera and Sierra Madre Mountains. This valley is drained by the Cagayan River. Before we have a short quiz, let's have a quick recap of our lesson today. In this Shench Amazing episode, we discussed the physical features of the Philippines focusing on Luzon. We talked about the Philippines as an archipelago, the three main geographic areas in the Philippines, which are Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. Aside from those, we also talked about the 8 topographic regions in Luzon. It's quiz time! To check if you can apply what you have learned or if you learned correctly in this Shench Amazing episode, let's have a short quiz. After 3 minutes, to check natin kung tama ang mga sagot nyo. Let's start! write T if it is true, then F if it is false. Number 1. The Candaba Swamp is located in the central plain of Luzon. This is T. Remember, the Candaba Swamp is haven for numerous waterfowls. Number 2. Western Cordillera is also called Sierra Madre Mountains. This is false. Kasi ang Sierra Madre Mountains ay nasa east. It protects us from the typhoons brought about by the Pacific Ocean. Ang nasa west ay ang Zambales Mountain Range. Which brings us to number 3. Eastern Cordillera is also called the Zambales Mountain Range. This is also false. Kasi ang Eastern Cordillera ay ang Sierra Madre Mountains. Number 4. Cagayan Valley lies between the Central Cordillera and Sierra Madre Mountains. This is true. Number 5. Binintiang Malaki is the main crater of Taal Volcano. This is false. It is just one of the craters in the volcanic island of Taal. Kaya siya na pagkakamalang Taal Volcano because it is more prominent compared to the real Taal Volcano, which is actually behind Binintiang Malaki. Number 6. Western Cordillera extends from Pampanga to Bataan. This is false. Western Cordillera is seen from Pangasinan to Bataan. Kapag Pampanga to Bataan lang, very short yon. You cannot consider that distance to be the Western Cordillera. Number 7. The Central Plain is the largest level, lowland, east of the Zambales Mountain Range. Number 7 is true. Lastly, number 8. Central Cordillera stretches from Kalinga to Bicol. Of course, this is false. The Central Cordillera does not stretch from Kalinga, which is in northern, to the southwestern, which is in Bicol. The correct range would be from Kalinga to Benguet, kaya Central Cordillera kasi nasa Central Luzon siya. Number 8 is false. That ends our short quiz. Please comment your score over 8 in the comment section. I hope you learned something. That ends our Shensha Amazing episode for today. We hope you learned a lot. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video to your friends so that we can learn together. Bye!